Local radio for the Merrimack Valley, 980 WCAP. Everybody gets it.
Good morning, listeners, and welcome back to the Internet Marketing and Business Solutions Radio Show with Ron Couming of both RCS Technology Solutions and RCS Online Solutions. Well, we help business owners and entrepreneurs achieve even greater success by attracting, converting, and retaining their ideal customers and clients using various internet marketing techniques and methods. The purpose of this show is the first two segments, we bring on subject matter experts from around the world to help business owners and entrepreneurs, much like yourself, learn how to achieve even greater success without having to go through all the pitfalls, because these people, the subject matter experts, already have gone through that. So by coming on the show and talking about what they do, who they are, and how they got to where they are, you can learn from them and avoid those pitfalls and get to being successful a lot more quicker. And also in the third section, if time allows, then I will give you some free tips on something that is timely to help grow your business. So we're pleased to have with us for our first guest today, Chelle Estades is a dynamic, dedicated business development coach that creates exponential growth for any business. Her proven Fortune 50 formula has created over $50 million in annual revenue with top multi-billion-dollar global companies like 3M, BP, and ExxonMobil. She is the authority for business expansion. You can find more about her if you go to her website, which is www.fortune50formula.com, to ignite and grow your business now. Chelle, how are you this morning?
I'm fantastic. How are you?
Excellent. And I pronounce your last name Estades. Is that correct?
It's close. It's Estades.
Estades? I wasn't even close, but thank you for being nice to me.
I've heard all kinds of things.
Yeah. I just got off a red-eye flight from California, and I got home, and now I'm doing the show. As you know, we're with the internet and everything, we can just fly around and do whatever we want to do. If I'm correct, you're calling in from Texas?
Yes.
Nice. How's everything down in Texas today?
It's wonderful. It's a beautiful day here.
Excellent. Well, I've met you before. I've talked to you, and I know just what a rock star you are, but could you please tell the listeners a little bit more about yourself, who you are and what you do, and how you got to this level?
Right. I've always been passionate about business since I was a little girl selling pizzas to my neighbors. So as I grew in my career, my background is chemical engineering, but I've done a lot of sales and business development over the last 20 years. I calculated it the other day, and I think I'm at about 40,000 hours of doing it. So I have a lot of experience, and I just love growing companies. So I meet with customers and our clients, and I talk to them about what they're doing and help them tweak it and get things moving in the right direction to grow their business.
Nice. I mean, that's a great generalization and overview, but could you tell us a little bit like your process? If somebody was just starting out, whether they're in business or if somebody was thinking about coming to you, what would be some of the first suggestions that you would give them? Part of the process, you know?
Yeah, so it's really important to know, it sounds kind of basic, but to know where you are and where you're trying to go. I ask them questions to see what's working, what's not working for them, what their vision of success is, how they're seen by their customers, how they want to be seen by their customers, what goals they have, what value that they have to bring to their customers. Until a client is really clear about what they bring to the table and what the customer needs, it's tricky to advance it. So these are very critical parts that sometimes even after years of being in business, these aren't clear. So once those become clear, then it's easy to strategize steps to bridge whatever gaps are there.
Nice. So you help them not only gain clarity, but then to execute the plan?
Yes, to make it simple. I think business is simple. People sometimes make it complicated. So it's important to simplify. What do you really bring to the table? What do the customers really need and are willing to pay for? And how do you get there?
Nice. So you basically help them understand all that, huh?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, cool. It's really neat whenever, like, I was talking with one gentleman, and he was really in his scientific mind and going on and on and on about, I guess, the features of his product. And I'm like, yes, but what does it do? Yes, but what does it do? And finally, we came to the conclusion that it was a manual technique to relax the central nervous system and create deep relaxation and release toxins from the body so that you could show up fully and engage more in life and not have those things going on in your life. And I was like, wow, that's powerful. And he goes, now it sounds powerful. Because I want, if your message isn't powerful, then you're gonna be lost in the weeds.
And I love it. And you're right. One of the things we focus on with our clients is to focus on the solutions. People aren't necessarily buying the plane ride. They're buying the destination. So if you get caught up in the details of, you know, what you do and how you do it, oftentimes, at least I've found in my industry and frequently with my clients, is that the client or the potential client, they kind of gloss over. This isn't their expertise. They're not even familiar with industry jargon. And so they kind of gloss over. But, you know, they want the results. They want the solution. So if you basically focus on the solution to whatever it is that, you know, that you provide, I think that goes over much better, don't you?
Absolutely. And you know, what I find is a lot of business owners are really confident about the value that they have and the value that they bring to the client, but they're uncomfortable about the sales process. Either they have a mindset about the sales process, meaning if you're selling, you're a bad person, or some sort of mindset thing going on. And I like to go through that process with them as well because, you know, the saying goes, everyone wants to buy, but nobody wants to be sold to. It's more like, you know, people want to know what they're buying and be invited into that world where they can experience what they want to experience. But they don't want someone pushing them there.
Yep, I love it. And that's another thing that we work with our clients on is, you're right, sometimes people will come and they'll feel like they're being a pushy salesperson. And I think a lot of it is how you present it. But if you have the solution to someone's problem and you don't let them know about it, or you don't reach out and you don't help them, I think you're doing a disservice. I think you're almost, you know, obligated to at least give them the offer and let them decide if it's a fit.
Right. It's an invitation.
Excellent. And so now let's say somebody was just starting out in business. Let's say we have three tiers of people. Somebody who's just starting out in business, maybe they literally just formed, got their LLC, or even if it's a DBA, and they're just going to get started, either they have or in the next month. Then the second level will be somebody who's been in business 12, 18, maybe 24 months. And then the third level would be somebody, and they're already breaking even or turning a profit. Then the third level is somebody who's been in business for maybe 5 years, and they're turning a profit, but they know that they're leaving a lot on the table. They know that there are many more people they can serve. So if you could, what would be like one or two or three maybe tips or ideas that you could give each level? And it's possible that one or more of the tips will apply to all the levels. So, but just to give the listeners an idea, and I want to make sure, too, that we get your contact info. We have another, 9 to 14 minutes, so there's no rush.
Okay, great. Well, as I answer this, a lot of this is based on my own experience, and then some of it is the coaching that I've personally received. I've done a lot of work with the J.C. Fox organization, and I've really honed in these skills to be able to answer this question. So if you're just starting off with a business, it's really easy to get caught up in the I'm going to be a millionaire immediately, quick fix, all of that. And then what I would say is the most important thing is to really think about what you have to offer and what is valuable and what someone is willing to pay for it now. So rather than waiting till you have the full plane built, if I use your analogy, rather than waiting till you have the full plane built and going and trying to get the biggest contract, start small and get those early wins soon. So, numbers on the board. As soon as you can bring in cash, then you can go back and improve it. So you might feel like you're only 80% there or even 60% there, but be where you are and get your traction as soon as you can and keep track of your numbers. Understand your numbers so that when you go back and look at them, you know what's working and not working. And a little bit of what I said before is really understand what you bring to the table, what you bring that is valuable, and what your customers need, and have a way of connecting those dots in a very strong manner where people understand it quickly. So that's when you're just starting off with your business. As far as when your business has been going a while and you're, let's say, breaking even or turning a profit, this is a good time to look at your business as a CEO and stay in your business looking forward. The CEO of the company, the owner of the company, is in the future. And if you get too caught up in the weeds, it can easily make you not profitable. So if you're spending all your time doing things that maybe you can delegate to someone else or you're not really focusing on what you bring to the table, then your business can stagnate. The other thing that's very important is have your systems in place so that you can transfer things. One of the things I do with whenever I go into a business is really understanding the systems they have in place and how to optimize. Sometimes optimize is how to grow it, and sometimes optimizing is how to cut it back so that everything that you do is valuable. So for a company that's been, I guess, that's in the third tier, that's been in business for 5 years or more, these things are still very important. Really, it's an accumulation of all of these. You definitely have to know your numbers. You should really know what's working and not working. This is really about learning the weaknesses and where things are breaking down. So if you're getting a lot of sales but you're not very profitable, then that sounds like you have to look at your systems and see if you're really optimizing and delegating everything properly and having the right tools in place for people to be efficient. If you're not generating the sales you want, the revenue, then maybe you have to look at your marketing and how much time and effort you're putting in sales and marketing. A lot of times companies, whenever they're not doing as well with sales, the first thing they do is cut back the marketing. But that's wrong. That's not going to get you more sales. A lot of times the branding you're doing, the marketing and the sales are the part that will drive your business forward. So it's really about taking a hard look at what you're currently doing and being open to improve.
I love it.
And number one thing I think is to get coaching. because they're going to see your blind spots and help you.
I love it. You hit on so many points. I actually started taking notes because I know you were going to hit. I did, because I knew you were going to hit on something else, and I was going to focus on that and forget the other stuff. But I like when you talked about, I think it was your second tip where you talked about getting out of your business and delegate. That's one of the main things I think is super important, and I try to instill in my clients too that if you really want to grow your business, you need to delegate. Learn it, do it, delegate it. You want to learn enough about whatever it is, you know, whether it's marketing or Facebook ads or how Facebook, so you're not being taken advantage of by somebody who you hire or delegate to. But you have to delegate because just like E-Myth Revisited by Michael Gerber, you know, if you're in your business, you can't work on your business. That's a great book. You also talked about how systems, you have to have systems in place. I love it, man. If you're speaking my language, and systems win, people fail. You know, if you have systems in place and they're not that difficult, listeners, systems can be implemented very easy. You know, not, I shouldn't say very easy, but, they can be, and they really need to be if you expect your business to grow and scale. And then you talked about coaching. I mean, that is huge. If you can get a coach or a mentor, Michael Jordan has coaches. Who played in Hannibal Lecter? Anthony Hopkins. I recently was talking with somebody who was talking with him, and he had 7 different coaches. Even for like when he speaks, when he does stuff on stage, that's one reflection, I think, of his voice. And then when he's on in movies, or you know, if he's on a play or in a movie. So these are people who are top-notch in their industries, and they go out and get coaches and mentors. So I'm amazed when other people don't. So I think you're giving people gems here.
Thank you.
We're going to have about another 5 minutes after, but I'd love the listeners. Can you give everybody your contact info? And if you have a newsletter or an ebook or something you'd like to give people access to, please feel free to do that. It's just another blessing that you've bestowed upon our listeners.
Absolutely. So I have one of the things I think will grow businesses faster than anything is the revenue part, and with that, the biggest driver for revenue that I have seen is really about follow-up. So I created a sheet that will help people will help them take a good hard look, because often you need 7 contacts with a potential client before you sell anything. And so if you know your numbers and you're tracking things and you're really following up on these very valuable leads you get in a timely fashion, you're going to grow your sales exponentially. So I can give that as a sheet, and I can also add them to my newsletter, which will be a monthly newsletter. They can reach me at Chelle, and that's Chelle, and at fortune50formula.com.
Nice. And I want to let all the listeners know this episode, as well as all other episodes, is recorded and archived. In about 3 to 5 days, I'll have it up on both the radio station's website, 980 WCAP, and also my website, RCSTechnologySolutions.com. Just go over to the media tab, and radio shows will pop up, and this episode and all the other episodes will be there. I tell you that because you're getting a lot of gems here and previously, but oftentimes you might be driving, you might be at work, and you're unable to write stuff down. So feel free to go back and listen. And also, if you are unable to write down Shelley's contact info or her free gift to you, which is a blessing, you can now go back and get that. Shelley, we got about 4 to 5 minutes left, and I want to give you that time to talk about whatever you want.
Okay. I guess I'll ask you the question. What are some of the top questions you get that I might be able to answer that would help your listeners?
I think the vast majority of our listeners are business owners and entrepreneurs and those who want to be. So if somebody is really starting out in business or they're thinking about starting out in business, I know you just gave them a tip, but what would be like one thing that they could do right away that would help them cut that learning curve? And I, my first thing would be get a mentor or a coach. But even if you give that as your solution, could you then follow up as why and how that will help them?
Why and how a coach will help them?
No, I'm saying that if somebody is thinking about being in business, what whatever, you know, what could you tell them that would help them cut the learning curve and achieve success quicker? And whatever solution you give, just say why that would help them. So they get the solution and then they tie in, they understand why it's going to help them.
Okay, well, you hit on it pretty strongly, and getting a coach is extremely valuable. When you have a coach, they're going to tell you what you need to hear, not what you want to hear. I think it's tricky whenever you're going into business, and especially if people around you aren't in business, that when you share your vision or what you want to do, they're really biased, and they might just tell you what you want to hear. A coach will, and that information may not be accurate, because if something I'm doing is just not working or confusing, my coach is going to tell me, hey, you need to change that. And you trust your coach and you change it. And if you don't have a coach, then you might spend a lot of time going round and round with things that you think are a good idea that won't make you money. There's a lot of projects out there that sound like a good idea but aren't profitable, or there's really no need. The value that you bring there's not a matching need out there. So getting clear on your message and what you bring to the table in a short way is very important. And then being able to have that message be of value to someone and doing it where they can understand the value that you bring. And a coach will help you through all of that.
Nice. Very, very good. And I absolutely agree with you. You're getting a coach and investing in yourself, whether you're going to different events. I just went to California. I went to Las Vegas for an event for 2.5 days with James Malinchek and Keith and Rachel. And then I also, from there, I went to another on Saturday to another event in Santa Monica with Ty Lopez, Neil Patel. Then the following Thursday, I went to another event. So going to these events, you learn things, you meet people, you continue to invest in yourself and grow, but also surround yourself, I think, is important with like-minded people. Because at the end of the day, you know, it's like 3% of us are true entrepreneurs and 90% of us, 97% are not. So it kind of, you know, it is isolating. So when you go to these events, you're learning, you're meeting new people, but you're also meeting people like us. You know what I mean?
Right. And it's people that are actually doing it. They're not just talking about it. They're doing it. There's a lot of times people are talking about doing stuff, but they're not doing it. And so there's a big difference between being around people that are actually doing it. It's really that social proof that we need, that one, it's achievable, and you're getting that opportunity to ask, hey, what's working for you? What's not working for you? And it can really get you going. It keeps you motivated, because being an entrepreneur is not easy. You wake up and there's days that you don't want to do it, or you're not as motivated, or you get a lot of setbacks. And the more you can increase your network to be supportive people that are going through similar things, your tribe, if you will, the more that you can supplement that setback, the setback ratio of, you know, getting knocked down or having challenges that come up.
Excellent. Very all true. I love it. All right. So I wanted to thank you very much for being a guest, and the listeners hopefully will take away from this some some great information and grow their business and cut out some of the pitfalls of losses. And I suggest that they get your sheet on follow-up, because if you don't follow up, you were never there. And thank you again. And everyone, you've been listening to the Internet Marketing and Business Solutions radio show with Ron Couming of both RCS Technology Solutions and RCS Online Solutions, where we help business owners and entrepreneurs achieve even greater success using various internet marketing techniques and methods.